Hi everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to talk about foundation and how to match it perfectly to your skin and how I actually add ingredients to make it better for my mature skin. So if you are interested in seeing how I do that, then please keep on watching. So I am moisturized. Let's get into this color matching do-it-yourself video for foundation. This is also good for mature skin. I'm going to show you what I do for my mature skin from start to finish. So first thing you got to know is what your tone is. If you can go in to like a Sephora or something and get them to color match you, that is wonderful. What you can also do is go into the drugstore and they'll have the foundations there. Most of the time they have testers, so you can just take a little bit out, put it on your finger, and what I like to do is go right about here. Right here is where I like to test it because this area here for me is usually red, so you're not going to get a really good color match from there. And then of course your neck, like here, is usually pretty light. If you're like me and you're out of the sun most of the time, I'm really, really light here. So I like to color match right about here. So if you can do that, then you can kind of figure out what your tone is. Now, Loreal is one of the foundations I love for going into the drugstore and color matching myself because they have all the tones, like whether it's neutral, warm, cool, they have it marked on the bottle. So then when you find the one that matches you perfectly, you know what tone you are. Mine is neutral, has always been neutral. Every time I pick a neutral, I'm pretty much bang on or very close. So I bought these at my local dollar store. This is just a little, you know, plastic container. There was three in the bottle. Hopefully you can see that. Yeah. It also comes with a little paddle, which is why I actually bought it, because you need something to mix that with. So this is the little paddle it came with. I've also found toothpicks work, you know, that type of thing. And also you can go into the makeup section. A lot of them, they have the little wooden paddles. They have them in a set of, I don't know, 30 or something. So that works as well. But in the dollar store, I found this. There was three of these and it was just like, oh yeah, that's mine. So it even has a little top container on it there. So that's different. So it has like a little... So it has this little top container. So I guess just to keep the lid from getting messy, which is cool. Because I know I'm neutral, now I can begin the next step. So what I did, I ordered online because I fell in love with this foundation when they sent me a little sample of it. I have been using this daily. This is beautiful. This is a light to medium coverage, and which is something that I like to wear during the summertime. I don't want a lot of heavy foundation on my face because it's so hot up here in the summer. It's like a sauna and it just doesn't work that great for me. Full coverage just makes me feel like I'm wearing a sweater. There you go. So anyway, this is the foundation that I've been using lately. Now don't get me wrong, I still enjoy my Lumi by L'Oreal. Still enjoy that, but it's almost gone. So I went ahead and I bought these. And I bought this one in 2N. I bought two colors, so 2N and 3N. Now the 3N, this one here, is a little bit dark for me, even though it's like in the middle of August, and I'm probably the darkest I'm gonna be. This is still a little bit too dark. This one here is actually a little bit too light, which is fine because that's what I was kind of going for anyway. But because they're neutral, they're both neutral tones. It's just that one is darker, one is lighter. So you can't really go wrong. So darker and lighter, there they are there. The other thing is, I usually like to put in a more full coverage foundation, just a dab, just to bring the consistency of these ones up just a little bit, but not a lot. So this is Uoma. This is a full coverage foundation. This is one of my favorite ones. I'm not going to use it today just because it matches me perfectly in the winter. So I'm just going to leave that one alone. What I am going to use, however, is the Infallable Pro Matte. This one is a full coverage. This one you can get at the drugstore, so that's why I don't mind using it. I'm going to put a little bit of this in my mixture because I want that little bit more consistency, but not a full coverage. So that's why I do that. And my favorite anti-wrinkle cream. So this is the Oil of Olay Age-Defying Anti-Wrinkle Cream. This one you can also get in the drugstore. We're going to use this one today. What you do is you take your little container here and you start mixing in your two foundations, so the lighter and the darker. And as you can see, I actually have one done. Now this one here I've been using for most of the summertime. Like I said, this is the darkest I'm going to get. I don't spend a lot of time outside in the sun. I just don't like the sun that much, okay? Make sure you have a wipe handy because you're going to want to wipe it off your face. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little drop of the dark one. So I don't want a lot of the dark one. And I put that much in there. I didn't put a lot, just a little 2 squirts of it. Then I'm going to take my lighter tone and I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to add a little more of the lighter tone. Maybe just an extra squirt of the lighter tone. So that's it there. And I'm going to start mixing those up. And the reason I like to use such small containers is because, like up here now, it's the middle of August, but we are already starting to get into the cool temperatures, as you can see. Sweater already. It is cold outside and windy. Now I'm going to just put maybe one or two little drops of this one. You don't need a lot because you don't want, for me, I don't want the consistency to be like full coverage. I just want a hint of that in there. So I'm just putting a little bit, like a tiny, tiny bit. If you can see it there on the paddle, that's all I put in there. And that'll be the only amount of this that I put in. Even if I have to add more of the other two, that's all I'm going to do with that. It's a good idea to, whatever you put your foundation on with, have it available and ready, because what I'm going to do is do my cheek here and I'm going to color match down into my neck. So I'm just going to put a little bit on my cheek. Just like that, because you don't want a lot. And just start patting it in and seeing how well that color match is doing. My hair is going to be annoying, I can see. I think I'm going to move my hair out of my way here because that little piece of hair is just going to bug me. There, that works a little better. Okay. So as you can see, I actually matched it pretty good. So I'm going to put a little bit more on just to be sure. So that is a pretty good match for me. As you can see, the color of my cheek matches my neck pretty close. Now, if you like to have a little more moisturizing foundation, which is something I like, especially with mature skin, you want as much moisture in your foundation as you can get. It just sits a lot nicer on your face. Like, I like matte foundations. I don't like dewy foundations, just because dewy foundations for me just seems like there's always something on my face. I can feel it on my face and it drives me insane. It's just all day, it's just I want to scratch it off. So I am going to add my favorite moisturizer, just a little dab, not much. Like that much. That's all I'm going to add. You don't want to put too much of your moisture in. You're going to thin out your foundation a little bit too much if you do that. For me, adding the moisturizer just makes the foundation sit that much nicer on your face. In a previous video, I believe I talked about this a little bit, but I didn't go into great detail about how I do it. Yeah. So this is the final result. And there's not a lot in there. Now I can fill this up a little bit more, but the problem is, like I said, now we're getting out of summer. It's already getting cool. Come September, the middle of September, I'm already going to be into a more lighter color. So I just like to do enough for, well, I guess this one's only enough for maybe a week. And the other thing is, don't try to pack it on real thick right in the beginning, because for mature skin, it's going to look cakey if you do that. It's always best to put it on little by little so that it doesn't look cakey on your skin. That's the one thing I do not like cakey makeup. So as you can see, it color matches perfectly, like from there to there. If you have a problem in color matching, like, you know, if you live, like where I live, it's hard to get into Sephora to get the foundations that I like, because I like the Uoma. That is one of my favorites. The Dior is one of my favorite light to medium coverage foundations. The sample pack, like this sample of Dior, came with a paddle. And I wish they actually had a paddle on in their big one, but they don't. But that's okay. So there is the one layer of my special brew. I'm going to just put on one more layer just where I kind of need it the most. I'm not going to put it like here. I don't need any more. Honestly, I have no problem issues there. My chin is a little red, so I'm going to need more there. But I do have problems with this area here. I always have that mark there. I'm not even sure what happened there. It just showed up one day and it didn't go away. All right, and I'm going to do under my eyes one more time. So here and here. All right, I am going to fix my hair. I'm going to go off camera now and do the rest of my makeup, and I will be right back. So there it is, how I find the perfect foundation shade for my skin all year long. It's easy and it's cost efficient. You don't have to go back to the store to buy a whole brand new bottle of foundation because your skin is lightened or darkened through the seasons. This way you can add more or less of what you need all through the year, and you can use up the bottles of foundation that you already have that you already like. This is the perfect way to do it. If you'd like to see more videos like this on how I mix and match some of my makeup, then please let me know in the comments below. I'm gonna get out of here now and get to my chores. Hopefully, I will see you for my next video. Bye.